Okay, so let's go see how elemental effects work with the bow. Because it does significantly less damage than my sword, but I mean that's deservedly so. Ow. Okay, correction, that does some damage. Oh, but that was the charge attack. I'm gonna lose all my armor by the time we're done with this, but that's fine. Make two of each weapon so I can try the upgrade paths. I could, and I will once I have the money for it. Right now, capital and resources are a little bit more important than... Okay. Yeah, bow's pretty good. I'll probably keep it around. Because it's certainly rolling these guys. We don't know about the status effects yet. So we'll see. New Binding of Isaac update looks amazing. Arrgh. I do actually really like this kind of gameplay style. How? I'm just gonna squander all of my armor here. Dang it. Like I said, squander. What? What? Double what? Are you kidding me? I rolled and fell into a non-cornered location. Oh, I've got my bow out again, thanks. I don't know if you guys saw that fall, but I fell right here. I know I probably must have hit that corner in, like, a weird way. But then when I got out, I immediately get sucked back into the slime, take some more damage, and then roll the opposite direction. Because I don't know which button makes me exit those guys faster. Well, it's fine. Let's switch back to this. I'm probably confident. Oh. You know, that's an interesting idea. The bow has a stun effect. I wonder how many times you can enchant a weapon. Okay. Are we playing the same game here? Ow. I love these new enemy types. Unfortunately, it looks like that's kind of the extent of this. I was hoping to get some extra early materials, but whatever. Let's see, what am I thinking? But yeah, I wonder if the reason why it's cheaper to upgrade low level, apart from, you know, the fact that you can't afford those enchantments, is actually because it really, like, the game really does want you to upgrade those lower tier weapons into being, like, high tier eventually. I don't know if you could afford this will require testing. I don't know if I'm gonna keep this bow, but I'll have to test that, because it'd be interesting to actually take, like, a really low level weapon, i.e. the broom? Ooh, you know, I think the broom is kind of a perfect test bed. How many times can I upgrade the broom? There we go, there's our answer. That's exactly what we need to pursue. Because if I can upgrade the crap out of that broom, it might have a cool effect. Or it's completely useless, who knows. I still would really wish this game had, like, a deeper customization system. Like... Oh. Interesting. I harmed him before the, before he had his shield up. I wonder if there's a way to get them to drop their shield for any reason. Probably not. It could be helpful. Okay, so we've got some options. We got some things I should muck with. I get a lot of cursed business. Oh. Because we want these to go up here. Because no matter what, I want to save those if I lose them. And that'll be fine for now. I wonder if I can hit this guy. There we go, got him. I wonder if I could hit him with a bow while he was flying. Probably not. It would be lovely, though. Let's see. Wander, is this the full game? As far as I can tell, yeah. They've made no indication that this game's gonna have an early access period. But some devs don't put that shit in until, like, the very end. At which point... Come on. You flash, dude. I guess it's immediately after the flash. Okay, so I don't get all those resources, but I'll live. Damn it. Man, it is mad easy to roll off the edge in this game. Yeah, I'm gonna hold on to the bow, I think. I'm underestimating. I have to more or less have to wait until he wiggles. Check the shop book top to see max fair price and bottom to see min fair price. I have no idea what you're saying, man. Okay, so I'm gonna sell these. They're cursed and they're kind of inconvenient and they're just gonna take up space. They might be more valuable, but it doesn't mean much. Value only matters a little bit to me. Because, I mean, I've already got almost 10,000 gold on only a couple episodes in. Like, it was a struggle to make cash in the original version of this game. It is no longer said struggle. That struggle ended. And now it's just been replaced by sheer capitalism, which is fine. Because it's going to make progression a lot easier. I remember struggling to even get some of the basic... Okay, yeah, definitely can't... Oh, come on! It hit the wall. Got lucky on that one. I think the stun slowed him down a little bit. Okay. We want to start selling things. I don't need as many sticks. In fact, I'm not actually sure if I need sticks anymore. And that's fine. Nope, just you. That's okay. I want that armor so my max HP is higher. Because then we can start doing the really silly stuff. How? How big is the hitbox on this sucker? Because he is definitely larger than he seems. Especially when he does that slide in. Okay, let's sell the grasses. I have yet to actually find anything that requires those. Same thing with the sticks. I can stack these together. I should be able to just bring all this back. Except for you. I'm just gonna sell, it's only one, and it's not worth keeping around something cursed like that. That stun is meaningless. It's like you stunned the enemy for half a second. I want to appreciate some of these mechanics, but they just don't seem like they're actually built for it. Can you not stack the pink stuff? This stuff? Or, oh, these crystals. Yeah, I could have. They were cursed previously. So I'd kind of forgotten about them. How much money do we have? We've got plenty. It's probably a good idea that I actually make multiple runs in. Or go on to the next. We'll see. It does seem like it would be worth upgrading, like enchanting my sword once. We're gonna have to fight the first boss before we get We're gonna have to fight the first boss before we get the future upgrade materials anyway. So no reason why not to. Wow, yeah, that stun really does nothing. Hopefully one of the other status effects actually has like a functional use. Cause it's like, I wanna say it's not even a half second stun. You could do something with a half second stun, but that's like enough to make him pause, reconsider their actions for a moment, and then continue on. Let me see. Have anything I can sell? I can probably just sell a bunch of the iron. I don't think I need that. Same thing with the grass and the teeth stone. Is that, yeah, I don't need any more teeth stone. And lore room. Okay, cool. So, despite my best efforts, we're leaving this floor with full health. Yeah? Yeah, good. And I'll probably warp back. Being able to make multiple runs on this place, or an attempt on the third level, one way or another, is going to be worth its weight in gold. I mean, honestly, one stack of probably these things is... Oh! We were on that floor long enough that it was aware of my existence. Or at least would be shortly. Okay. I'm just gonna scum cheese the crap out of you. Oh! Hi! We got a sword! A training big sword. Alright, hold on. I like the looks of what's in my inventory right now. Let's go until I take a little bit more damage. Oh, there's this. Read. I need empowering crystals to enchant my weapon, but those seem really hard to find. They do not seem to be in chests. Okay, well that's not actually new information. I can go just a little bit further. We have yet to run into something that I can't deal with. So I think that arrow actually has a bit of a homing effect to it. Only the charged arrow, though. Not the other one. Okay. Yeah, we've got a ton of empowering crystals. So I might warp out of here, do a couple cycles, maybe. We'll see, we've got the healing area. Yeah. Can't hit him with a bow. Seriously, that stun should absolutely ground these guys or something. Oh well, it's a lot easier to fight them with the ranged attack. Okay. Well, for starters, let's send that sword home immediately. Switch these. Send that home immediately. I'm just gonna send everything valuable home for a second. We've also got... This destroys, I'm just gonna sell it. Probably same thing with these. And I could leave... Oh, no, that door is to go to the boss. We don't want that. Really? Huh. Dungeon's smaller than I remember it being. Get him? Got him. Alright. What do we got in here? So I could actually fight the boss if I wanted to. Not sure if that's really what's in the cards for me. No. What we're gonna do, I'm just gonna offload some of these things for a bit. Okay, so we've got a bunch of destruction-related things. But that's fine. I've got easy ways of dealing with that. Move this here. We probably don't need the twigs at this point either. This will decurse something. It's me. No, I don't have any more of those. Okay, I'm just gonna sell the spare white stone. Inventory's full of that. Do we... Man, hard to say what I want to do on this one. Because I could just bum rush the boss. Try and fight it. I don't have enough money to get an enchantment. Oh, we don't have enough masonry, do we? My treasure chest. I didn't know those things could even move them. Okay. Yeah, having a bow is worthwhile. I just hope I can get something that does, like, a damage over time effect. Otherwise, it's probably best that I just get, like, another base level bow. But I'm That's why it was movable. Probably gonna blow most of my potions trying to kill this sucker. Okay. I can hit him. Oh, he's loose. Got him. Okay, so he has healing potions for days. Good, we needed those, and... Just another one of those. Yeah, let's... We haven't got what we needed. So let's give money to this. I think I know how to do this. Okay, so that gives me a gate. Do we sell anything? Yes. I'm just gonna sell that. It's actually worth a fair bit. Don't want the teeth stone, actually. I want the golem cores. They're not worth much, but I might be able to do something with them. We'll see. Okay, so we're going back to town. Now, what this has done is this has given us a portal back. It means I can actually just... Oh. Oh, we're committed. That's interesting. It's a bit of a nerf, actually. A bit of a nerf. We found out that 300 was a ridiculously low price for that. Let's set it up to 500. And 300 is a ridiculously low price for this as well. Now that's the old minion golem design, sure. Because we never really did find out what's the viable price on these. What about the water lamps? I don't think the water lamps are worth much. See, golem manuals are unpopular right now. Oh, nope. We don't want to sell these. Bad move. Rune tools, which I think were worth a lot more. What about these? People liked that price. People like that price. And yeah, 300 is too cheap on that one. What else do I have? Glass lenses? Sure. They don't sell for much, but they will make me some money. Okay, and then this is just all the stuff that I don't need, save for these two. Check in. Oh, I'm gonna wanna change this around. Because now that I'm looking at it, we wanna put the stuff I wanna keep at the foot of my bed. And then these chests over here are going to be the ones that I... Oh. Well, the mirror even works. That's cute. The golem design is underpriced. Set it to 500. Set this to 600. We'll see. I'm sure I'm going to be selling things underpriced for a while. Okay. Now... Let me see. Yeah, I need a lot more masonry to get what I need on some of these. I've got 5 potions, though, which is kind of nice. But yeah, unfortunately, I don't think I can go back into the dungeons. If I go back into the dungeons, it might muck with time? So I'm just going to go back in this way. We'll see. Okay, wait, what? 0% exploited. Thanks. That worked out real well. I'm surprised I haven't gotten any masonry on this run. It's not a big deal, but masonry does kind of help a lot. Okay. Damn it. Okay, it just spits you out in a random direction. So it looks like using the portal actually resets all the enemies. It's odd. Oh. Yeah, all of the enemies. Including the mimic, which is actually a bit of a boon. It's a weird one, but free potions are free potions. I'll take them. Of course, it's messed with the map and some other things. And it's thrown me off like crazy. I was not expecting the enemies to respawn like this. And it has wrecked the map, yeah. Okay. I'm just gonna grab what materials I can. I have some ideas. So part of it is, usually when I use that portal, it used to let you, oh. This sucks. Okay, there we go. Okay. You're nasty. Okay, we'll hit him here. The problem is he likes to fly at random angles, making it real hard to cut him down. There we go, got him. Mine. Okay, got it. There's a chest here. Yeah, it's like it reset the entire dungeon design. It's very strange. I was not expecting this. But it works. Okay. So what do we got here? Random stuff. 2 destruct... things related to destruction. Got enough of a safe spot away from the explosives now. I can go for these. But I might make an attempt on the boss, and I might die, but that's actually fully planned. Because what I could do, what it might do, is it might set it so... It might give me that play again option. Are you serious? Come on. Because it gives, if it gives me the play again option. Ow. Then what I can do is I can run through the whole dungeon a second time around with all of my stuff. We'll see if that's a functional exploit. I haven't gotten a whole lot of resources. I was stuck in the skeleton, that's why I couldn't run by it. No, I'm still stuck in the skeleton, it's just broken. QA? I'm gonna call these things piss buckets from now on. They've gotten definitively pissier over time. Luckily, they're easy to fight, so it's not that big of a deal. Let's see. How are we doing? Do we have any resources that I desperately need here? I'm gonna hold on to the... Do I hold on to the healing potions? I'll probably hold on to the healing potions. The rest of these aren't gonna make that much of a difference. And we have a lore book, but I think I've already read this one. They're like moths, moths of the flame, blah, 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 blah. Okay. So, we've more or less cleared this floor out. And I can't go back to the previous levels. And the map is broken. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna head for the healing fountain. And we're just gonna go to the last floor. Probably. Because if I head to the last floor, maybe I can fight the boss. It's a bit of a Hail Mary. Oh, this chest is... Oh! This is a chest. Okay, well, whatever. Let's Hail Mary this and see if it's a boss fight. Oh, shit, it's just a boss fight right here. Alright, do we have our affairs in order? Yeah, if I die, I lose pretty much nothing. And keep all the goodies. Yes! Now, I've already fought this guy before, but if you guys haven't seen my closed alpha footage, you should probably watch it. This guy did some weird shit. Wait, you can stun the boss. You can't stun him for much. What's he doing now? I don't know. He's aiming? Oh! Okay, there's some answers. Okay, watch out for that. I assume I cannot hit his fist. Oh, but I can hit him. And I've got a healing potion. Okay, what's he doing now? This again. Oh, that's fine. He's gonna swing towards me. Ow. Still got me. Okay, so it seems like the bow might be my best option. I'm still probably not going to be able to get him on this run. We'll see. I'm learning his pattern. It's just a matter of not getting hit by shit like that. And getting the hits in while he's swinging. Okay, new one? Nope, same one. Sort of. Can't do anything to him. Same deal? Okay, it's coming back. Is that it? There we go. And we don't have any more slimes. He's almost... Okay, just gotta watch out for the flying fist. Got two more potions left. We might actually make it to the forest dungeon earlier than I thought. Oh, with great gusto, Crane's great must monster... I don't know, words are hard sometimes. Yep. Shit. Okay, this makes this easier, actually. Damn it. Okay. I didn't get him as well as I was hoping on that one. I got one more hit, but I can probably healing potion up. Okay, and same deal. I'm afraid to walk into that fist. Luckily, the hitbox on that one is tiny. Now, what's this one? I can just barely get it. What if I block it? Oh. I can block it. Okay. I've taken some damage, but he's dead. Sweet! Got him! I was actually not expecting I'd take him out this early, but I did! I swear he had extra patterns previously. But maybe it's just me. Okay, so we've got some stuff that I've never seen before. Golem King Energy Crystal. I bet I'm gonna have to farm this sucker. In fact, nope, never mind. I don't know. Whatever. Hello. We get goodies. Okay, time to start offloading all of my crap. I have many. Let's see. Many pieces of junk and useless garbage. And things that are significantly less valuable than what he's throwing at me. Awesome. And now we can get out of here. Is that... That white orb is his eye. I assume I can't pick that up. Yeah, congrats. It bounced. I'm gonna clear out one more bit of inventory space. What can I... Oh yeah, I can get rid of the grass. I assume I can't pick up the eye. Nope. But I can bat it around a little bit. Like a dingle hop. Alright. Let's just leave that behind. Alright. We beat the boss. We got some stuff. And let's go make some money. Oh shoot, I didn't get any masonry there. Oh. But it's nighttime again. Question mark. What is happening with time? We ported back to town, it was day, and now it's nighttime again. Okay. Question mark?
It was you, wasn't it, Will? The one who defeated the Golem King. Boy, you put yourself in such unnecessary danger. A lock on the door opened. Maybe Pete was onto something. Regardless, just leave it. That door isn't worth your life. Pete didn't heed our warnings, and, well, due to the buzz your heroics are creating, the town's decided to reopen the forest dungeon. But with the Golem King dead by your hands, now is a great time to focus on the Moonlighter. Take advantage of this momentum and expand the shop up a bit. The town board should show what contractors are available. Somewhat strange travelers looking to set up shop as well. Shop in town as well. He specializes in crafting odd ornaments and such. Could make for some great decorations once you've expanded. And finally, Andre over at Vulcan's Forge is preparing some new gear. He predicts an influx of materials from the forest dungeon to occur as people become more brazen due to your recent actions. Go there, see what he can offer. I won't have your demise on my shoulders, boy.
He is very doom and gloom about everything. He's like, you're going to die. Farewell. Okay. So. Yeah, all forest dungeon equipment. Stuff that I haven't seen before. I could actually make a big sword, but I don't think it's worth it. The max cap on damage, it does end up being 100 more than the small sword, but the speed, the loss of speed is rough. Yeah, I bet getting some of these more expensive. Jeez. The price on some of these things is way high.
Okay.
I guess let's enter. Let's drop off our resources. And go from there. What are these, by the way? Golem history. I assume these are sellable. I look at how we're getting these, like, rare and valuable things. And we're just like, Well, that's worth a lot of money. And we're just going to sell it.
I bet they're worth a shit ton, though. Okay, those I'm going to overcharge on. Like, crazy high.
And we're going to work our way down. Because it's not worth, squandering whatever profit margin I can get off of those. I mean, at this point, I can start high and sell, and, like, go low. Easily.